My name. Now, there's a letter in this word that shows up twice. It's used two times. Which letter?
S.
And you know why that's an important letter? Because that's the letter, the very special letter for today. Yeah, it's for Sesame Street, and it's today's letter, the letter S.
Say hey, I'm Sammy the Snake, and I'm here to tell you people something about the letter S. Oh, I'm Sammy the Snake, and I look like the letter S. Oh, yes. I'm all wiggly and curvy, and I look like the letter S, I confess. But do you know the sound? Sammy the Snake. Well, the sound of the letter S is the sound I make. I say sss. Let me tell you about it. Out of sight. I say sss in the morning, sss in the afternoon. Yes, I do to all my snake friends. I say see you later, Slinky. She's my sister. I say see you soon. Yeah, she's super slick. Yeah, I'm Sammy the Snake, and I have to confess that I look and I sound just like the letter S. Now come on, all you children, and make that S sound with me. Here we go. Yeah, that's fine. That's the sound you hear at the beginning of a word like sing or story time. Let's do it again. Yeah, you hear that sound at the beginning of a word like seesaw, silly, super, star, seven. Yeah, I'm Sammy the Snake, and I have to confess that I look and I sound just like the letter S. So long.
S. Serpiente. Ese.
Todas estas cosas van juntas, todas estas cosas son casi igual. Todas estas cosas van juntas, es hora de empezar a jugar. Bueno, lo que tenemos aquí son tres figuras, casi todas del mismo tamaño, ¿eh? Y aquí tenemos dos figuras, dos triángulos, uno grande y uno pequeño. A ver, fíjense ustedes bien y a ver si pueden adivinar cuál de estas dos cosas va aquí. Una de estas cosas va con las otras. Pueden adivinar cuál de ellas es. Si adivinaron que esta cosa va con las otras, entonces tienen absoluta razón. Claro que sí. ¿Y por qué? Bueno, si se fijan ustedes bien,
Estas tres figuras que teníamos aquí eran del mismo tamaño, ¿verdad? Bueno, así es que este triángulo es del mismo tamaño que estas. Así es que si adivinaron que este era el que pertenecía con estas, adivinaron muy bien. Porque este es triángulo grande y no cabe aquí con estas. Todas son del mismo tamaño.
Wow. Tickle. And these are tickling things.
Ernie.
Yes, Bert.
Oh, Ernie. What? Ernie, what are you doing with those cookies in bed, huh?
Well, the cookies? Well, I was just hungry, Bert, so I thought I'd have a few cookies before I went to sleep.
Ernie, don't eat those cookies while you're in your bed, huh?
Why not, Bert?
Because you get crumbs in the sheets, that's why.
Gee, Bert, I'll get crumbs in the sheets?
Yeah, Ernie, if there are crumbs in the sheets, they'll get in your pajamas.
Ooh, crumbs in my pajamas, Bert?
Yeah, Ernie, and if you get crumbs in your pajamas, they'll make you itch, you know.
Oh, I don't like to itch, Bert.
No, and if you itch, you won't be able to sleep, Ernie, so don't do it, okay? Good night.
Oh, gee. If I eat the cookies in bed, I'll get crumbs in my sheets. And if I get crumbs in the sheets, I'll get crumbs in my pajamas. And if I get crumbs in my pajamas, I'll itch, and I won't be able to sleep. Oh, Bert! Thank you so much for stopping me from eating cookies in my bed.
All right, Ernie, just go to bed, though, okay?
Okay. And I'm never going to eat cookies in my bed again.
Okay, good. Ernie, what are you doing?
I'm going to eat cookies in your bed, Bert. Move over.
Oscar, hi. What are you doing?
Go away.
Oscar, what are you making here?
I am building something. Can't you see I'm busy?
Yeah, I can see you building something, but I really got to know what it is.
Well, I'm just finishing an invention, and if you don't mind, I'd like you to go away so I can get it all done.
Oh, come on, Oscar, don't be like that. You know how much I love inventions. Why don't you tell me what it is? I bet it's a jukebox, huh, with a light machine on top. Sure, the music comes
all
out.
All right, I'll tell you what it is. It is not an electric light machine or a jukebox or anything like that. Yep. Let me make one more adjustment here. I think it's ready to turn on for the first time.
Be careful, Oscar. You got this thing says volts on it. That's
got
electricity.
Oh, that's right, it's electric. Don't worry, but there. Okay, now, let me turn it on here.
Wait.
There.
Oh, sure, it's a light machine, huh?
No. Okay, now, let me ask it something.
Ask?
Okay. What are you?
I am an automatic grouch.
You see?
An automatic grouch?
Right. I figured, in case I ever go away, yeah. I can leave this automatic grouch here. He can take messages for me, stuff like that, you know? And anyway, I wouldn't want to leave Sesame Street without a grouch.
Oh, no, we certainly wouldn't want to be without a grouch.
So, hey, would you like to give it a try?
Yeah.
Just ask it if, it would want a, an ice cream cone.
Oh, okay. Hi there, say, fella, how would you like a nice ice cream cone?
I hate ice cream. Ice cream is yucky, yucky, yucky. Rather have some sour pickles with chocolate sauce.
Oh, wow, that's an automatic grouch.
That sure is. Okay, I got some more details to finish, so will you please go away and let me get back to work?
Okay, okay.
Wow. Oh, easy, Oscar.
Don't worry, Machine.
Careful. Careful, Oscar.
Just adjusting your friend's trick.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. She's a real Martian beauty, my number 9 cutie. She has 9 hairs on her head. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Tied up in ribbons of red. She has 9 little eyes, all the same size, looking up, down, round, and straight ahead. She has 9 little holes in her turned up nose, and she snores when she goes to bed. She has 9 arms, that's one of her charms, each just like the other. Some people say she looks like her dad, some say she looks like a mother. She has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 little toes on her foot. She doesn't go shopping cause she doesn't like hopping, so usually she just stays put. 9.
B is for bicycle. B is for bear. B is for bug. See him fly through the air. B is for branch, sticking out of a tree. Too bad, Mr. Bear. B is also for bee.
You, Oscar, I got your mail for you.
Who is making all that noise? Go away and leave me alone.
Who are you?
I am an automatic grouch.
An automatic grouch?
Oscar is not at home. I am watching the place for him.
Oh, well, Mr. Automatic Grouch, I wonder if you could do me a favor and give Oscar his mail when he comes back. Would you please?
Who cares about mail? Probably a lot of silly cards and letters. Just take your silly old mail and throw it away.
Well, for goodness sake! For goodness sake, I know!
Molly, you got some mail from me. What's the matter?
Susie, you're not going to knock on Oscar's can now, are you?
Yeah, I was going over to invite him to lunch.
Well, good luck, Susan. That's all I can say, dear.
Good luck?
Good luck.
Oscar! Oscar! Come on, Oscar!
I know you! Who are you?
Who is it now?
Well,
I never saw so many nosy people in my life.
Nosy?
Everybody banging on my can. Can't a guy get any peace and quiet around here?
That, my dear, is what's called an automatic grouch.
An automatic grouch?
Mm.
Well, I came to invite one grouch to lunch. A grouch is a grouch. I might as well invite this one. Maybe I'll get to know him. But Mr. Automatic Grouch, would you like to come have some lunch? I don't know. What do you eat? I made some tuna fish salad, though.
Black. Who would want to eat that stuff? I already had lunch of motor oil. And mud sandwich. Now go away and leave me alone.
Go away and leave him alone?
How do you like that?
Oh, brother. Get used to one grouch, and here we got this one.
He's worse. And an automatic one to boot.
Oh, brother. Oh, hi, Louise. How are you?
Excuse me.
Louise! You're not going to go and open the can and talk to Oscar, are you?
Why not?
Well, he went away and he left an automatic grouch in his place, and it's meaner than he is.
Automatic grouch?
An automatic grouch.
You won't believe it.
This I gotta see. Hey, Oscar!
I am really getting mad. Why is everyone disturbing me? What is it now?
Well, look, I finished fixing Oscar's transistor radio. I thought maybe I'd bring it back and give it to him. But would you give it to him?
I will not. I hate people doing nice things for me. So take your dumb old radio and get lost.
For the nerve!
Yeah, you know what? It's one thing to listen to that coming from Oscar, but from a machine? It's too much.
I saw it.
It's too much. It's too much.
A boy named Jack took a letter B and planted it in the ground to see if the letter B would really grow. So he watered it, and what do you know? A bee stalk grew. It grew so high it disappeared up in the sky. Well, Jack climbed to the very top, and what he saw made him gasp and stop. For Jack had arrived at the land of B. It was big and beautiful, and Jack said,
Gee!
Not G, it's B in our fair land, for things with B are really grand. We ride in buses, we ride on bikes, and bananas are the food that everyone likes.
What's that?
Our zoo, and you will see the animals' names all begin with B, like bears and buffaloes, birds and bees. Don't feed the animals, if you please. The games we play begin with B, too, like baseball and basketball, to name a few.
Oh, here's the bee stalk. I'd better get back before my mother calls. Oh, Jack! I've got to go. She's calling me. It was great to visit your land of bee. Boy, that was fun. Oh, what a day. Wonder what would happen if I planted a K.
Janelle and I are going to count to 20. Here we go. One.
What?
Uh-oh, who starts first? You start first.
One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
10.
11.
12.
13.
14.
15.
16.
17.
18.
19. 20.
That was mine!
Hey, Molly, Susan, Libby's, why are you so quiet and your faces are so long and everything? What's the matter?
Have you gone over to Oscar's can? Did you see that automatic grouch he's got there?
It's like a jukebox. I saw it. It's yours.
Yeah, well, boy, did he do a good job on that thing. I went to ask it to lunch and it told me my food was yucky and get away from the can.
And I asked him to hold Oscar's mail till Oscar came back and he told me to throw the mail out.
I took a transistor radio back that I had fixed for Oscar. You know, he told me to get lost.
He's worse than Oscar.
Ridiculous.
He's worse than the grouch itself.
Hey. I've got an idea. Well, that thing is a machine, right?
Yeah.
It's got wires and connections back there. Mm-hmm. Now, I think if I worked on it and made the right connections, that I could make it not grouchy.
Yeah, you mean if you just changed... You could change make it friendly if you just change the wires now?
If the insides of that thing are like I think they are, it shouldn't be too hard to do.
Oh!
I'll grab some tools.
Grab the tools.
All right.
We'll see now.
Okay. I got all kinds of
stuff. You got some stuff?
Yeah. Hey, automatic grouch, come on out for a second. Hi, remember me?
What?
Hold on to him, Molly.
What is going on here?
Nothing.
I never saw such.
Get this.
What are you doing?
Screwdriver.
Take
it easy.
What is this?
It won't
hold it right there.
What are
relax.
You?
Don't worry, sir. Why is...
Thank
you. That must be what is known as a tickle.
Take it easy. Everything's going to be fine.
Wrench!
What?
Hold it down now.
Where?
I...
The doctor's not going to hurt you.
Hey, I think I've got it.
Okay.
That's it. Wait a minute. I'll just turn the switch on here right now.
Hello, my friends. How are you this lovely day?
It worked!
It worked, huh?
Hey, I'm going to the florist shop to get some flowers. You want to go with me?
I would love to. I love beautiful flowers.
All right,
they are so pretty. but I have to stay here until Oscar comes home.
Oh, but when Oscar comes back, can you go with me?
Oscar should be home very soon.
Great, then we have a date?
We have a date. You are a very nice person.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
If I knew that you were going to be so upset about it, I mean, I wouldn't have changed it, you know? Well, listen.
You changed it?
Yeah, why don't I change it back to the way it was before?
No, okay, you'll feel happy. Well, never mind. Don't you touch my grouch machine. If you made it nice, well, I'm the one that built it. I can fix it back into a rotten, nasty machine.
What
again.
Do you mean?
I can just put the wires back where they belong. I don't need any help from you, but you better stand back. There's a lot of electricity in
here. Yeah, but Oscar, you shouldn't fool around with stuff that you don't...
You sure you don't need any help now, huh?
No, I don't need any help.
Stand back. I'm
let's see, this wire goes over
Oscar,
here.
Oscar, careful, those wires, you know, get pulled out.
I know this wire's in here. I built it.
I know, but...
Let me fix this. Oh, wait a minute. This part, you moved over to there. Oh, let me disconnect that. I think it broke.
Oscar, what did you do? Are you okay? What happened?
I put the wrong wires together, I guess.
You sure did.
Oh, gee.
Oscar, I'm terribly sorry. You see, all this happened because I redid the wires and everything. I'm really sorry. Why don't you let me fix it and put it back the way it was, huh?
Are you kidding? Are you kidding? I want to say thank you. Why, this is beautiful.
What do you
this
mean?
This is better than ever.
What do you mean?
Well... This is the most beautiful piece of junk I've ever seen. I'm going to put it on my coffee table where everybody can see it. Anyway, it's more fun to be a grouch by yourself than have a machine do it for you. Maybe I might put it on a mantelpiece. Sure is nice.
Mm-hmm.
Stairway, calling a name that's lighter than air. Who's bending down to give me a rainbow? Everyone knows it's windy.
Hey, kid, here's your rainbow.
Yeah, thanks.
Nothing.
Who's tripping down the streets of the city? Ooh. Smiling at everybody she sees.
Hello.
Who's reaching out to capture a moment?
Gotcha.
Everyone knows it's windy.
Hey, kid, tell them about my eyes.
And Wendy has stormy eyes that flash at the sound of life.
How about my wings?
And Wendy has wings to fly above the clouds.
That's right, up there.
Above the clouds.
Yeah, and my wings are beautiful. Hey, kid, now tell me the truth, okay?
Uh-huh.
Who's tripping down the streets of the city?
Oh, you are.
Smiling at everybody she sees.
Catch you all over.
Who's reaching out to capture a moment?
Oh, everyone knows it's you, Wendy.
Aha! Uh-huh. Stand clear. Here I go. Zoom.
Wow. Look at her go. Stormy eyes that flash at the sound of life.
Oh boy.
And Wendy had wings to fly.
Wow.
Above the clouds.
Oh no, I ain't going up there again.
Above the clouds.
Not me. Oh, my back.
Wendy?
Yeah?
You okay?
Oh, I don't know.
I did okay that time, huh?
Once upon a time, in a palace in a faraway kingdom, there lived a king. And one day, an awful thing happened. The king's palace caught on fire.
Help! Help! Oh, my goodness gracious me, my palace is on fire! Firemen, firemen, come quick!
Here I am, Your Majesty, with my trusty hose
yes.
to help put out the fire.
Do it! Do
here
it!
Here I go.
Well, the firemen arrived just in the nick of time to put out the fire, and of course the king was grateful. In fact, he was so grateful, he issued a proclamation.
I now hereby proclaim that from now on, everybody in my kingdom will quit his job and become a fireman. You got that? Good.
So everybody in the whole kingdom quit their jobs and became firemen. Well, it wasn't very long before the king began having problems. For instance, one day he was playing with his erector set, and he cut his finger.
Oh, I cut my royal finger. Oh, doctor, come quick. I need someone to help me. Doctor!
I used to be a doctor, but now I'm a fireman. Maybe if I blow my siren, it'll help your finger. I hope that helped.
Oh, I hurt my raw finger and there's no one to help me. Oh, woe is me. Oh.
So there was no doctor to help fix the king's royal finger. And as if that wasn't bad enough, the next morning the king had another problem. He was waiting for his mail.
Oh, where's my royal mail? I'm expecting a royal letter. Postman, postman, where are you? Huh? Postman.
I used to be a postman, but now I'm a fireman.
But who's going to deliver my mail?
I don't know, but you want this hose?
No, I can't read a hose. Take that away. Oh, oh, woe is me, no royal mail.
And as if that wasn't bad enough, it wasn't long before the king got hungry.
Oh, oh, I am starved. Where's my royal cook? Royal cook, bring me my royal lunch. Where are you, royal cook? There's that bell again.
Monsieur, I used to be a royal cook, but now I'm a fireman because that is what you ordered.
But I'm hungry.
Here is a fireman's hat. Would you like to eat that?
Take that hat away. No, I don't want that.
Oui, monsieur.
I'm hungry and there's no one around but firemen who give me hats. Oh, woe is me.
Well, the king was very upset and realized that he had made a mistake. So you know what? He made a new proclamation.
I hereby proclaim that everybody should go back to his old job. And from now on, only firemen should be firemen. And everybody else should just do his own thing.
Oh, fantastic. Now if you cut your royal finger, I'll be able to fix it.
And I can deliver the royal mail whenever you want it.
And I will cook the royal meals whenever you are hungry.
Whoopee!
Oh, that's good.
And they all lived happily ever after because the king had learned his lesson. You see, it takes all kinds of people to make up a world, right? And if everybody had the same job, it'd be pretty hard to get along. And pretty silly, too.
Oh, isn't that nice? Gordon is reading a storybook. I wonder if it has pictures. He seems to be enjoying it, doesn't he? And there's Bob. He's making bubbles. And Gordon wants to play with the bubbles. But Bob won't give them to him. Bob said no again. Oh no, now Gordon has the bubbles and the book. And poor Bob. Bob has nothing to play with. Oh, very nice, Gordon. Now you each have something to play with. See how cooperation helps everybody?
There are many words that begin with the letter S. For instance, there's the word, subway. Sailboat. Sled. Scooter. Skates. Skis.
But there's one word that starts with S that I particularly like.
S. Skate.
S. Swing.
S. Salt. S. Sad.
Hi, I'm a seal. Seal begins with a letter S. Can you say S? Try it. S. Oh, very good. Now, I want you to listen to a little story. There are a lot of words in it that begin with a letter S. Listen for them. Six silly sailors came skating down our street. They passed a smiling snowman wearing sneakers on his feet. Then they spied a schoolyard So they took turns on the slide. And all played on the seesaw. Three sailors on each side. Hey, great! Isn't S a swinging letter, though? Oh, you bet it is. Well, see you later. I'm gonna go have a sandwich. Another nifty S word?
And now, once again, from her cozy cottage in Goat Corners, New Hampshire, it's time for the Answer Lady. And here she is, the lady for whom all questions have an answer, the Answer Lady, Granny Fanny Nestleroad.
Hello there, hello there. It certainly is.
Well, fine day, Granny. Good to see you.
Oh, it's good to see you, too, you handsome brute, you.
Here's your first letter. It comes from a Mr. J.M. Charles of East Winesap, Minnesota.
East Winesap, how sweet.
Yes, Mr. Charles
Lovely
would like
place.
To know. He
what?
Says,
what?
Dear Granny Fanny.
Woo, that's me.
Yes,
yes,
I've been trying to call you on the telephone for
you
a
have.
Long time now,
Is
but
that
you
right?
never answer.
Oh, no kidding. Well, I certainly answer my telephone.
Yes.
I answer it any time it rings.
Well, why don't you answer that phone
I
now,
I wish this
Granny.
Telephone would stop ringing so I could concentrate on your letter, though.
Just
you see.
Answer the phone,
Oh,
Granny.
All right. I'll answer it. Hello there. Hello there. Hello, telephone. What do you want, telephone?
Granny, you have to pick it up
oh,
to
telephone.
Answer it.
You do what?
You have to pick it up.
You have to pick it up. All
yes.
right. Yeah, I don't know why, but hello there. Hello there. I'm picking it up, but it doesn't seem
no,
to do any
Granny,
good there.
No.
Oh.
You have to take that top part off there.
You
have
to
pick up the receiver.
Pick up the receiver part
that's
here,
it.
Like this.
Yes, that's
well, let's
it.
See. Hmm.
Now, well, find out who it is. See who it is, Granny.
See, I don't see anybody in there at all.
Granny.
Hello
well,
there.
No, Granny,
Hello.
You don't look into it. You talk into it.
Talk into it.
Yes.
Hello there. Hello, this is Granny Fanny Nestleroad. Come in, please.
No, Granny, Woo! That's the wrong end. No, you're talking
oh.
to the other end.
Oh, I see.
Yes,
sort
there.
Of like this.
Fine.
Hello there. Hello. Oh, hello. Hello.
Yes, who is it, Granny? What do they say?
Oh, it's someone going...
Well, let me hear that.
Humming like that. See that? Singer, probably.
Oh, yes, that's
know?
The dial tone, Granny.
The dial tone.
Yes,
oh,
they probably got tired of waiting and hung
oh,
up.
Hello,
we'll have to wait
tone.
For them to call back.
Oh, all right.
Granny.
I wish they'd hurry.
What are you doing?
I'm waiting for them to call back.
No, Granny. You have to put it down before they can call back.
Put it down?
Yes.
All right, if you say so. There.
No, not on the table.
Right,
no, you have to put it back on the phone.
Oh.
On top
on
there.
On top of the telephone, well.
Yes, sir.
You insist. You're smart yeah. aleck, you.
Now.
Oh, it's the telephone. I'll
okay.
answer it. I'll answer
yes.
it. And let's
it
see.
Right
I'll answer
time,
it correctly
please,
this time.
Good.
I want to make sure I do it just right. I won't pick up the whole telephone like that. I will only pick up the top part of it
you
here.
You better hurry, Granny.
And let's see. Well, I want to make sure I'm doing it right.
It's going to be too late before long.
I want
long.
To be sure to talk into, not that end. Yes, that end. I'll talk into this end. And I say, hello.
Wait, Granny.
There we go.
You, there's somebody on the other end
Whoa,
of the wire.
The telephone rang again. I must answer it one more time. And let's see, I won't pick up the
I'll
whole thing.
I'll answer it this time, Granny.
No.
Well,
I'm
that's
it.
All the time
I'll
we have
right.
for today, folks. So
here,
be sure to tune in next week when Granny
end.
Fanny Nestleroad will present some of her most fascinating telephone conversations. Well, let me get that, Granny. I'll answer it.
A circle
begins with a circle.
A triangle.
An ice cream cone.
A bird.
A bird.
A
clown.
A bird.
A mouse.
He's eating cheese.
A carriage.
With a circle.
It's a man.
It's a boat.
It's a boat.
Boat.
A sailboat.
It's a lady.
doggy.
A doggy.
With pants. It's raining.
Let's see.
A bird.
A bird.
Cat.
Oh.
I love cats.
A face.
Eyes and a nose and a forehead.
A tree.
A seesaw.
Now it's only just a
lollipop.
Lollipop or a balloon. Now it's just a plain ball again.
This goes away.
You know, there are a lot of people that we haven't met around the neighborhood yet. Let's see if we can meet a few more, all right? Oh, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, in your neighborhood. Say, who are the people in your neighborhood? The people that you meet each day.
Excuse me, sir. You know what time it is? We're late for class.
Say, you must be some of the new people around the neighborhood.
That's right. We'll give you clues.
Okay, let's do that.
Yes, we work with blackboard and
blackboard
chalk.
And chalk.
And we work usually in a big building.
And
we work with children.
Yes.
I know who you are.
What?
You're teachers.
Right. Oh, a teacher works the whole day through.
To teach important things to you.
We'll teach you things you won't forget, like numbers and the alphabet.
'Cause the teacher is a person in your neighborhood.
Yes, in your neighborhood.
They're in your neighborhood.
Yes, the teacher is a person in your neighborhood. A person that you meet each day.
Let's take a walk down the street and see if we can meet some other people, okay? Hi there. I don't think we've met him before. How are you?
I'm all right, I think. Mm-hmm.
You're all right?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
I see you're selling magazines.
Yeah, sure. Magazines, newspapers, anything like that.
You must be the news dealer, right?
Of course I'm the news dealer. Oh, the news dealer's the man you need. If you want, I got some stuff to read. If you want a paper or a comic book, well, my newsstand is the place to look.
'Cause the news dealer is a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
And the teacher is a person in your neighborhood.
They're the people that you meet
when you're walking down the street. They're the people that you meet each day.
Hey. If we call this the same, and we call this different, what do you call this?
Same.
And this?
Different.
And this?
Different.
And?
Different.
And this?
Same.
And?
Different.
And?
Same.
And?
Different.
Hey, Ernie. Hey, the place looks great. Look at all the decorations.
Yeah, doesn't it look nice, Bert?
Yeah, what are the decorations for, Ernie?
Oh, well, this is a very special occasion, Bert.
I know. Yeah, it must be a special occasion. That's why the decorations are up.
Right.
I'll guess, okay? I'm going to guess what the special occasion is.
Okay, Bert.
Okay, let me see. It's somebody's birthday, right, Ernie? That's it. Must be somebody's birthday. It's Maria's birthday.
No.
Bob's birthday. That's it.
No.
It's Big Bird's birthday.
Nope.
It's my Aunt Matilda's birthday, and you remember. She'll be so happy.
No.
What'd you get her?
No, Bert. No.
What?
That's not it. You
not
give
it.
Up?
Yeah, I give up. What? Tell me who.
Well,
we're having
a very special visitor, Bert.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
A special visitor?
Yep. You want to know who it is?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, who is
it? Okay, well, it's a very special visitor, and that's why I've decorated the whole place up.
Yeah?
Take a look. Look
what?
Look right in there, Bert.
In there?
See right in there? Yeah, look a little closer. See who it is? See, Bert?
Oh, yeah. Well, hi. Boy, I sure am glad it's you. Gee, this certainly is a special day.
Oh, look at this crazy mirror. Hey, you look funny. You look funny. I look funny. Look how squashed we look. We look like a couple of squashed tomatoes. Do you see that? What a crazy, crazy mirror. There's another crazy mirror. Should we take a look in there? Oh, look. We look upside down. Oh, that's a funny, curvy, crazy mirror. Look how long we look. Look how Shannon, your neck is so long. Well, look at Rachel and Molly. Our necks are long, long like an animal. I know, long like the animal, long like the neck of a
giraffe.
You're right, of a giraffe.
You know what this is? It's the letter S. And it stands not only for Superman, but for a lot of other words as well. Speed, for instance. And sky. And spaceship. Also stands for sea and sailboat and storm and sinking and save and sand. Yes, sir, S is a very important letter. So the next time you think of Superman, think of the letter S. It's my favorite.
Got a painted nine.
Bert, hey, I was just wondering if
Ernie.
You could help
Ernie.
Me because I thought, what, Bert?
Ernie, tell me, why is it that every time I sit quietly down to read a newspaper, all Ernie comes in and bothers me? Why is that, Ernie?
Were you reading the newspaper, Bert?
Yes, I was reading this newspaper.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I won't disturb you again. If I have anything to say to you, Bert, I'll write it to you.
You just do that.
All right, Bert. I'm sorry.
Psst. Hey, Bert. Bert. Hey, Bert. Excuse me, Bert.
Ernie, Bert. You said you would be quiet.
Oh, yes, Bert. Well, I'm not going to interrupt you or anything
like
that.
Well, you are.
Well, you see, if you could just help me by telling me how you spell the word help.
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 Help. All right. H-E-L-P. Help. Okay?
H-E-L-P. Thank you, Bert.
You got it. Okay. Now leave me alone, Ernie.
I won't interrupt you anymore, Bert.
Help. Help. I wonder why he needs that. It's probably something silly.
Bert, excuse me.
Ernie,
I don't want to interrupt you again. Well, I just wanted to ask if this is how you spell the word help.
H-E-L-P, just like I said, help. Yes, Ernie, it is.
That does spell help.
Yes.
That spells help. Thank you, Bert.
All right.
I won't interrupt you anymore.
All right! Help. I wonder why he needs the word help. Maybe he is in trouble. Maybe old Ernie really does need some help, and I've been sitting here reading the newspaper all the time. Maybe old Ernie's sitting there all alone, and he's crying for me, saying, Bert, Bert, help! And I'm here I am, sitting here reading the newspaper, telling him not to interrupt me. Ernie, come here! Ernie, what is it, Ernie? Tell me, what is it?
Help
do you need?
I don't want to put the newspaper down.
I'm here now.
But I don't want to interrupt
your newspaper reading,
Bert.
You just go right ahead. Tell me.
But that's okay, Bert.
No, go ahead. Tell me what you need help for. Tell me.
Well, you see, I was just fixing a plate of cookies.
Yeah,
because
what happened? You burned yourself?
I thought you might be hungry, so I did a sign that says, help yourself. Want some cookies, Bert?
Help yourself.
One of these books is not like the others. Which one is different, do you know? Tell me which book is not like the others, and I'll tell you if it is so. Well, which one is not like the other books?
The little one,
and it's not like the others because it's small, and these are big. That's little, big. Hey, who wants to go to the library?
Me.
Okay, let's go.
Me.
All right, both of us. All three of us.
Hi. Do you know what this word is? This word is help. H-E-L-P. Help. Do you know what else about this word? It is heavy. Help.
Need help?
Yes. So heavy.
Okay, here you are. The word help.
But
H-E-L-P.
Two helps? No, help, help.
You need more help?
Yes, help. So heavy. What you doing? Three helps. Help. Help! Help!
Need more help?
No, I'm okay. Everything's just fine. Help!
I'd like to tell you a little about the letter S. S stands for more words than any other letter in our alphabet. I'll show you a few. Snow. Santa. Where's the sleigh? Get the sleigh. Slay.
En este plato tenemos tres galletitas. Una, dos, tres. Y aquí tenemos el número tres. Este número quiere decir que tenemos tres galletitas. Pero si ponemos otra galletita en el plato, tenemos una, dos, tres, cuatro galletitas.
Excuse me. You know what those are?
Uh-huh. Galletitas.
Galletitas? Me thought they were cookies.
Oh, but they are. You see, in Spanish, cookies are called galletitas.
In Spanish, the word for cookies is galletitas?
Uh-huh, yes.
Then me love galletitas!
Y eso termina la discusión para hoy, porque no hay más galletitas. Y no hay más números.
B is for bicycle. B is for bear. B is for bum. See him fly through the air. B is for branch, sticking out of a tree. Too bad, Mr. Bear. B is also for bee.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
Do you know what the name of that letter is?
Yes. That's an S.
Right. And do you know what the sound of the letter S is?
Yes. The sound of S is...
Yes. And how did you know what the sound of the letter S is?
Well, the letter S looks like me. I'm a snake. I always go...
I see.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters B and S, and by the number 9. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.